स्टूडेंट, स्वागत है आपका आपके अपने यूट्यूब चैनल SRGCHOD इलेक्ट्रिकल पर एक बार फिर से नए लेक्चर के साथ। दैट इज लेक्चर नंबर 12 एंड द टॉपिक इज एसी वोल्टेज कंट्रोलर। सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ऑन ऑफ कंट्रोल ऑफ एसी कंट्रोलर। नाउ एंड वी हैव ड्रॉ द वेव फॉर्म फॉर डिफरेंट पैरामीटर्स ऑफ द कंट्रोलर एंड we have also determined the RMS value of output voltage and RMS value of output current. Now there are some other parameters that we have to determine, and suppose we have to calculate average output voltage. So you can see here that this is the average output voltage. This average output voltage consist of one positive half cycle and one same negative half cycle. That's why average value of this output voltage over the complete cycle will be zero. So V naught average will be equal to zero. So I naught average will be equal to what? That is V naught average divided by R. That will also be equal to zero. Okay. So in that way we have determined the RMS and average value of output voltage and output currents. So we have calculated four parameters. Now we will see the average value and RMS value of thyristor currents. Okay, means IT1 and IT2. So RMS value of thyristor current. Okay, so you can see here two thyristors are connected in anti-parallel, like that. Two thyristors are connected in anti-parallel. This is suppose T1 and this is T2. Okay, dekhiyega, isme current kitni hai aapki? This is IT1 aur isme current kitni hai aapki? This is IT2. Means the contribution of both the thyristor is equal for sharing the output current. You can see here, this is thyristor current IT1. During positive half cycle, we are getting this thyristor current IT1. During negative half cycle, this is IT2. So if we add IT1 and IT2, then we will get the output current. Means the contribution of thyristor T1 and T2 is equal. Okay, so we can write that IT1, that is phasor sum of IT1 plus IT2 will be equal to phasor I0. Okay, we can write, because these contributes the in output current equally. Okay, so hum likh sakte hain RMS value of output current I0 R is equal to under root of IT1 R square plus IT2 R square. That is the RMS value of thyristor current T1 plus RMS value of thyristor current T2. Now you can see here that the RMS value of IT1 and IT2 same, because you can see here they have the same value over same time. From 0 to pi, you can see IT1 is Im, this is equal to Im, and this is equal to minus Im from pi to 2 pi. So the RMS value of IT1 and IT2 will be same, and you can also calculate, you will get the same result. So here I am directly written that IT1R is equal to IT2R, that will be equal to, suppose this is ITR. Okay, so I node R we can write that is equal to under root 2ITR, or we can write that ITR will be equal to I node R square divided by root 2. Sorry, this is square. So it will be ITR is equal to I node R divided by root 2. Okay. सो अगर हमें थायरिस्टर की आरएमएस वैल्यू निकालनी है, करंट की आरएमएस वैल्यू निकालनी है, सिंपली दैट विल बी इक्वल टू आई नोड आर डिवाइडेड बाय रूट। ठीक है, एंड यू नो आई नोड आर इज नथिंग बट इट इज इक्वल टू वी नोड आर डिवाइडेड बाय आर, एंड वी नोड आर इज इक्वल टू नथिंग बट इट इज
under root duty cycle into RMS value. Supply voltage we have derived already. So in this way we can calculate the RMS value of thyristor current. Okay. Next we will see the average value of thyristor current. Average value of thyristor current. Average value of thyristor current. Thyristor current. Okay. So you can see here we can obtain the average value, and if you can see that IT1 and IT2 both are the half rectified wave. Okay. But we have n cycles. So first we will calculate the average value of this IT1 or IT2 over one complete cycle, and then we multiply with duty cycle. So IT1 average will be equal to IT2 average. You can see here both are the half rectified wave, that's why average value of both the current will be same, and it will be equal to, suppose this is IT average. So IT average is equal to, this is duty cycle, that is duty cycle is n upon m plus n into average value of thyristor current over one cycle. So one cycle is nothing but it is the one cycle. Sorry, this is one complete cycle. This is 0, this is pi, and this is 2 pi, this is omega t. So you can see that this is the half rectified wave. This is 3 pi, this is omega t. Having peak value is Im. So the average value of this half rectified wave is nothing but it is Im upon pi. The value of this is Im upon pi. So we can write that average value of thyristor current will be equal to, that is IT average is equal to n upon m plus n into Im upon pi. You know very well that the average value of half rectified wave is how much? It is equal to Im upon pi or Vm upon pi. Okay. So Im is nothing but Im is equal to Vm upon R, and Vm is nothing but root 2 times of Vsr divided by R. So IT average we can write, that is n upon m plus n into root 2 Vsr divided by R. We have calculated the relation Vsr, because the peak amplitude of both the input voltage and output voltage is same. Okay. Now we have to calculate the input power factor, because the supply is here AC supply, sinusoidal AC supply. So we can calculate the supply power factor or input power factor. So let's see how to calculate the input power factor or supply power factor. This is input power factor. Sometimes it is called as supply power factor. ठीक है. So मैंने आपको कई बार ये बताया था इन्वर्टर में भी, कि जब भी हमें इनपुट या सप्लाई पावर फैक्टर कैलकुलेट करना है, वी विल कंसीडर दैट द स्विचेज आर लॉस लेस स्विचेज, एंड वी विल एज्यूम दैट द टोटल इनपुट पावर विल बी इक्वल टू टोटल आउटपुट पावर. So whenever we have to determine, either it is the case of control rectifier, it is the case of inverter, and you have to calculate the input power factor, simple, you can put the input power equal to output power, because we consider that the thyristors or any other semiconductor switch as lossless switch. Okay. So here we can put input power is equal to output power we can put in. Input power that is the AC power input. So RMS value of supply voltage, this is VSR. RMS value of supply current, that is ISR, into this is suppose cos phi S. Cos phi is S is the supply power factor, is equal to output power. Output power V node R into I node R, and since the load is resistive load, that is cos phi R, यह आउटपुट लोड का जो पावर फैक्टर है वो क्या होगा, हमारा यूनिटी होगा. तो सिंपल फ्रॉम हियर वी कैन राइट cos phi s इज इक्वल टू v नोड r i नोड r डिवाइडेड बाय vsr इनटू isr. ठीक है, और आप देख रहे हो कि जो हमारी सप्लाई करंट है, यू कैन सी हियर द सप्लाई करंट एंड आउटपुट करंट आर सेम. इट मींस द RMS value of output current and RMS value of supply current will be same. So since I naught R is equal to ISR, so cos phi S will be equal to this is V naught R divided by VSR. So in this, that way we can find the supply power factor. Okay, so these are, we have tried to cover all the parameters of a on off controller या ऑन ऑफ एसी वोल्टेज कंट्रोलर. ठीक है, इस तरह से हमने सारे लगभग पैरामीटर कवर कर लिए हैं. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस ए प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन दिस ऑन ऑफ कंट्रोलर. सो डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज ए न्यूमेरिकल दैट वी हैव टेक दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन ऑफ एसी वोल्टेज कंट्रोलर. You can see here that an AC voltage controller has a resistive load of R is equal to 10 ohm. Means here the load resistance R is equal to, we have, that is 10 ohm. And RMS input voltage of 120 volt, means supply voltage RMS is equal to 120 volt. And supply frequency F is equal to, it is, sorry, this is 60 hertz. This is 60 hertz. The thyristor switches are on for 25 cycles, means the on cycles n is equal to 25 and off for 75 cycles. Yani m is equal to how much? This is 75 cycles. Okay. Determine number one, RMS value of output voltage, that is V node R. So first we will calculate the duty cycle. So duty cycle is duty cycle. Delta is equal to, this will be n upon m plus n, that is how much, that is 25 upon, it will be 25 plus 75, its value will be 0.25. okay, it will be 0.25. this is the duty cycle. Now the first case is output voltage RMS value we have to calculate, that is V node R. So we have derived V node R is equal to under root delta into VSR, that is RMS value of supply voltage. So it will be under root of 0.25 into supply voltage is how much? It is 120 volt. It is 120. So we will get the value of this voltage is equal to 60 volt. After calculation, you will get that is 60 volt. ठीक है? उसके बाद in second part, he is asking that what is the value of supply power factor. So we have derived supply power factor cos phi of S is equal to V node R divided by VSR with lossless switching devices. So V node R is how much? This is 60 and VSR is equal to 120. So it will be 0.5. The power factor will be 0.5 lagging. It will be 0.5 lagging. Okay. Now the third case is we have to calculate the average value of thyristor current. Average value of thyristor current. So IT average. So we have derived formula for IT average is equal to, that is N upon M plus N, that is duty cycle, into root 2 VSR divided by pi into R. This is pi into R. So you can put these values. So IT average is equal to, this is a duty cycle, and the value of duty cycle is how much? It is 0.25. So it is 0.25 into root 2 into VSR is how much? It is 120 upon
3.14 into 10. So after calculation, you will get the average value of thyristor current is equal to 1.35. It will be 1.35 ampere. So this is the average value of thyristor current. Similarly, we can calculate the RMS value of thyristor current. So IT RMS that is ITR is equal to ITR is equal to how much? We have calculated the formula, that is I naught R divided by root 2. And I naught R is nothing but this is V naught R divided by R into 1 upon root 2. So ITR will be equal to V naught R, we have obtained that is 60, and load resistance is 10, 1 upon root 2. So it will be 6 upon root 2, or it will be 3 root 2 ampere. This is the RMS value of thyristor current. Okay. So in this way, we have determined all the parameters that were asked in this numerical problem. Okay. So is lecture mein itna hi. Thank you for watching the video, and I request to subscribe the channel, share and like the videos. Thank you.